You don't really get tested like this in fights too often, I guess. Where did you kind of find it inside, you know, to kind of turn things around when it needed to happen? And then, you know, what kind of changed the fight for you? Did it feel to you like your power would overcome him at some point?
Yeah, I mean, the main thing is that I wanted to be patient. I mean, Caleb Plant is a great counterpuncher. As you can see, he's really fast. I didn't want to just go in there and get countered with any, you know, shots. You know, I really had to take my time. I think you guys seen a good jab. My jab was way more effective than Caleb Plant's. You guys are only talking about Caleb Plant having a more better jab and stuff like that. But as soon as I got in there, you know, the fight is not a 4 or 6 round fight. It's a 12 round fight, you know, so you got to start slow. But as soon as I, you know, I found my groove, there's nothing you can do to stop me. You know, I hurt him to the body, hurt him to the head, cut the ring off pretty good. And like I said, I'm just satisfied with this. There's a lot of things I can fix in my game, but overall, I'm satisfied with this. This is my first fight pay-per-view. This is the biggest fight I've ever been in. This is the biggest fight in my life. And I feel like I did amazing. You know, I mean, we went out there. I told you I was gonna put a beat on Caleb Plant, so that's what I did.
Quick question right here, David, in front. After seeing your stablemate Ryo lose the way he did on those judges' scorecards, after that bout in the 12th round, after it rang, did you guys have any thoughts or like second guess that maybe the judges would go against you guys?
That's a good question. I wasn't thinking of that at all. I mean, I was just a little disappointed because I thought Ryo was more effective. You know, he rocked him a lot. That was his fight. You know, I had to fight. He fought his game. You know, I had to fight my game plan. You know, I couldn't think if the judge were gonna rob it. You know, so I just had to keep fighting my game plan, stay disciplined, stay focused, and you know, that's exactly what I did.
David, right here, brother. Steven Cordano, KLR Sports. Congratulations, man. Talk to me about the end of the fight. The bell rings. You raise your hand. You're kind of walking around the ring, and Caleb comes up to you, kind of puts his arm around you, and you guys exchange words. Talk to me about that moment there.
I just told him, you know, man, sorry for all the trash talk that we went at each other. You know, we talking a lot of shit to each other, and a lot of it, I'm not gonna say it wasn't necessary, because it was necessary, because this fight is huge. You know, it's a huge fight, and sometimes that's what you need to bring the best out of two men. And we're both warriors. He's a warrior. You know, he definitely showed it, but I showed it that I'm the better warrior. And I wanted this opportunity to be challenged by a top super middleweight. You know, he's definitely top three. You know, I'm top two. The number one is Canelo. So, I mean, we both had a lot to fight for. You know, the winner supposedly is going to be Canelo. And, you know, so I put everything into this training camp. You know what I mean? And I know he did too. But, you know, at the end of the day, I don't want to hold no grudges against nobody.